What's going on, guys? My name is Dustin, and this is End on a Make. And tonight, I just wanted to talk a little bit about the not-so-good streak that the Houston Rockets are on. Earlier today, they lost to the Oklahoma City Thunder to drop to 20-game losing streak. It's not quite the record yet. The record is actually held by the Philadelphia 76ers from a couple seasons ago when they were still right in the thick of the process. And that was 28 games, but that goes over two seasons, because it started at the end of 14-15 and then carried into the start of 15-16. So the Rockets are in kind of unprecedented territory here for losing streaks, just in the season. Through this losing streak, they have taken 16 of their 20 losses by double digits, and the last time they won a game was February 4th against the Memphis Grizzlies. And in about a week and a half, we could be looking at two straight months without a win. And obviously, you know, this is not where you want to be. But, like, even as someone who doesn't like the Rockets, who just, like, you know, I casually like some of the players. I really like John Wall. Christian Wood's been a breakout before he got hurt this year. Victor Oladipo, I still really like too. I know he's you know, been a little inconsistent since his injuries and everything. But, like, it's a likable group. And at the top of it all is Steven Silas, first-year head coach, goes from thinking he's going to get Russell Westbrook, James Harden, all these guys, and PJ Tucker, and then next thing you know, it's, you know, John Wall and Victor Oladipo, and Christian Wood gets hurt, and Eric Gordon's hurt now too, and it's just been a disaster. And he gave this press conference today, and it just started, I don't know if you saw this, if you're watching this, but they were like, does it take a toll? And you could just see, like, the pain in his eyes as he's like, yeah, it's not fun. I'm not here to lose. And, like, the bummer is, if they don't get it turned around, or if the Rockets, for whatever reason, decide, you know, hey, we're going to let you go, like, that could be it for head coaching chances for him for a really long time. You know, we've seen how rare it can be for minority coaches to get that chance in a head coaching role. And, you know, something like this, even if everything is out of his hands, essentially, with how much, you know, roster turnover there's been, all of the injuries they've had, the lineup changes pretty much every night, it's just, you know, it's a shame to see, because I think he's a good coach. I think, you know, given a little chance for consistency, he can prove himself as a good coach. But, you know, it's just, it's rough right now. Today's game, you know, was kind of a fitting summary for the whole losing streak, in that Lu Dort really just keeps clamping down on offensive stars, and today was no different. He clamped down on John Wall at the end, got two key blocks, and then forced him into a terrible long range three with like 4 seconds left on the clock to end the game with Houston down two, looking to try to tie. So, you know, he needs to be in that first team all defense discussion, because he is absolutely clamping people right now, and it's a huge part of why the Thunder have been so surprisingly good this season compared to what everyone kind of thought. And something else that's interesting is they didn't have Shai Gilgeous, they didn't have Mike Muscala and Al Horford, and I think Darius Bazley. They were missing a couple key pieces. So this roster, no one on the team was over 23 years old. And they came out and just played hard and scrapped and got the win. And, you know, I don't know if that's more of, you know, how hard Oklahoma City's playing right now, or how lost Houston is. But, you know, it's impressive. It's impressive either way for OKC to be getting wins like this without, you know, key pieces like Shai Gilgeous-Alexander is like the franchise cornerstone right now as they try to figure out this rebuild. Or if they're just going to keep collecting assets. I mean, who knows? But back to the Rockets, on the Rockets' end, I feel really bad for John Wall, because he's one of my favorite players to watch. And coming back from those injuries, everyone was like, no, he's going to be terrible, he's got the worst contract, he's got, you know, all these negatives. And then he started the season off, like, wonderful. Like, he looked great. Like, the team looked a little, not, like, above average, but they looked average. They looked better than I think people expected after, you know, not seeing him for 2 years and not seeing how these guys would mesh. And then you like throw in James Harden just not playing, or when he is playing, not trying. And, you know, John Wall looked really good, and he's had a pretty good season. Like, they've been careful with his injuries. He's gotten, you know, back-to-backs off and rest nights and all that. But he's looked really good when he's been on the court for the most part, which I think is something that not a lot of fans would have seen or predicted, you know, right before the season started even. And that kind of brings me to the last point that I want to make, which is the trade deadline is next week. And I'm guessing the Rockets will probably be pretty active. But at the same time, it's hard because, like, John Wall's contract is huge. I think he's, like, the third highest contract in the league. And I don't think they're going to be able to find a buyer for that. I don't know what they could put with it. I don't know what picks they have. I mean, unless it's, you know, they're unloading some of the picks that they got for James Harden. But at that point, you know, why would you do that just to get rid of the contract? Their best trade piece really is Eric Gordon, and he's going to be out for like 4 or 5 more weeks with a groin injury, which is just, you know, it's terrible because I'm sure he was looking forward to going to a contender and trying to make another, you know, legitimate run into the playoffs here. And instead, Houston's without their big trade chip. He's going to just be on the shelf. Like, maybe a team takes a flyer anyways and says, you know, we'll stash him until he gets healthy and then have him ready for the run. But there's no way Houston's getting back what they probably would have if he had stayed healthy. So really that just leaves Victor Oladipo. And I've read a couple different things about, you know, where he might be heading. He could be going to Detroit, I guess, was a popular one I was reading. He really wants to go to Miami, and that kind of complicates everything too, because he's on an expiring this year, which means he's free agent next year. He could just walk for anyone that trades him that he doesn't want to stay with. And that's another thing that's going to just ruin the leverage that the Rockets have to get anything substantial back for him. It's just, you know, it's a tough spot. It's a tough spot to be in for a new GM, a new coach, just a new regime, really. And I'm really interested to see what happens, because I don't know what trades are out there for Oladipo when most of the NBA world knows already that Oladipo just wants to get to Miami. And that's been his, you know, his coveted destination for, I think, the last season, maybe season and a half. But yeah, that's about it. So the Rockets play again Monday night. They have a back-to-back. They're going up against the Raptors, who are also coming off of a back-to-back. They just lost to the Cavs tonight as well. So, you know, maybe this is the game the Rockets break that streak. After that, they have the Wolves twice, the Hornets, who will not have LaMelo Ball for the rest of the season. They got the Grizzlies, who ironically are the last team that they beat. That was who they beat in Memphis on February 4th. And then, you know, after those games, it gets really tough again, and they start to see, like, Boston, Brooklyn, Phoenix, the Pelicans, like, their schedule is going to just crank up after those, like, 5 games. So if they don't get the win in here, then it's going to be really hard to project when they could actually break the streak, which is just, you know, crazy to think how fast things can change in the NBA. Like, granted, you lose Westbrook, you lose Harden, but, like, that stability, you know, you lose Daryl Morey, you lose Mike D'Antoni, and then the foundation just immediately crumbled down, and they're in the midst of a rebuild, basically. Let me know in the comments, too, what you think the Rockets might do, if you think there's any players that are going to be worth them going after, if you think there's going to be a substantial Oladipo trade, or if there's another player on the roster that you think they might be willing to trade. Just let me know. I'd love to hear it. Thank you if you watched this whole thing. Thank you. I appreciate it. And I will be back soon. Thank you.